Welcome back, Hookaholics. It's another Anglers Anonymous haul reveal. cabin fever got the better of me, and I was out once again at my local Ollies, and I just decided to get a big old sack of different lures. So I figured, you know, a final hurrah before the season, I might as well just do a little reveal of some of the things I got. So I'll pour these out here, and we'll just make a quick little video of some of the stuff that Ollie's right now has on sale. First and foremost, I got some of these 3-inch Matsudo little crankbaits. So these are square bill crankbaits. I got this one here is 7.6 centimeter. Let's see, what do they got? The Sexy Shad. I've got it also in your typical chili craw. I got it also in a bluegill pattern. You know, so I figured, you know, pretty good. These have got the pendulum technology, so the weight inside is actually in a crescent shaped weight transference device that they have in there. It's basically tethered to the top, and that little ball will pendulum back and forth, adding a clack and adding a different weight distribution for a more erratic, kind of lifelike rocking motion. Slow rise action, and, you know, $3.99, but I did use my 10% off discount, so you can do the math on that. So I got those three baits there. Let's see what else I got. I'm saving some of these for later. I got quite a few. A little Strike Pro here. This is a redhead diamond patterned. This goes 0.6, so it's basically half a foot depth for my little micro fishing. My little Plano small light tackle bag, I'll do that. There's a Norman Lures. This is in the chrome Tennessee shad color, the little N. This is another little diver. It's got that black glimmering pattern. Let me just crack this open because this one's hard to see with the black on the black packaging. Norman Lures, pretty darn good. I always have liked their chrome that they have to things. So this has got that light bronzy, you know, chrome black flash. I think that'll work well. You know, decent little diver, little crankbait. Drop it in the carpet. See you there. I got, here's another one from Berkeley. Right, here's a Berkeley Fusion. This one is a Pitbull 5.5. Let's see what else. I think I got a couple of these. I'm not sure. I'll have to go through here in a second. Got a little bomber. Alright, this is $3.99 for the Berkeley, $3.99 for the bomber. Again, with that 10% off discount. I figured I need a little kind of jerk bait, a little diver. So I figured I'd pick that up. Berkeley, this is a 5.5 foot diver. In a 3/8 ounce. I figured, and it's a silent, so for the finicky fish, it's a little bit of a see-through crawl pattern. I just like that. That was a color that kind of caught me. There's another little Strike Pro in a small little half-foot depth. Again, for that light line presentation, they recommend, oh, this is Lemon Lime. Lemon Lime, that's a good color. I did get a few bobbers because, I don't know, it's rare that I find the wood tone in a bobber, so that caught my eye, and it was 99 cents, so I figured, I don't actually bobber fish a lot, but I intend to start doing a little bit more carp fishing for grass carp, common carp, that kind of thing, and I think, you know, when you're carp fishing, it's a bobber fishing sport, so I figured I could use those. Here's another one. This one here is in the black diamond. To go along with that other one. That's another small little Strike Pro Tormentic Grade light line fishing bait for my little pan fishing. I got some small, this was 99 cents for some Mustad little jigs, little tiny jig heads. Again, for my soft plastics and my small bag. I'm trying to boost up a lot of my small tackle. I've always had larger tackle because I've gone for larger you know, predatory fish, but I want to get more into the light line fishing and more pan fishing and stuff like that to keep myself a little bit more busy and active in more finesse techniques. Here is a Here's a Smithwick suspending, little jerk bait. They call this one Rogue Red Bream. So I like that. That color caught my eye. I think this also would catch, you know, we got pike and muskie, but I think this would catch some pike in my little local lake that has them. And, you know, there's some other predatory fish that might actually go for that pretty well. Certainly the muskie will. I got a large jointed. This is only $2.99. Again, it's a Strike Pro. This is suggested retail price of $13.99. Yeah, okay. But this one is the gold pattern. It is just like those small jointed ones that I got for my smaller kit. I decided I wanted to see what this one's action will be like. So I think this is more or less a saltwater bait. Or an inshore bait, because it's got those saltwater style hooks. But again, it's that jointed, flexible serpentine, similar to the Savage Gear Snake in its styling. Again, it's got that two wires that run down the length of it. Obviously, it's a flat bill, so this is a wake bait style design. I think it's got VMC hooks on it, so I think this was actually a good buy at $2.99. I just couldn't pass it up. The VMC hooks is what really sold me on that one. I do have, and I did get some saltwater tackle. This is Hurricane's saltwater. This is their jig heads for shrimp, for their little plastic shrimp imitations. But I think this would work just as well in freshwater doing crawdad imitations, because I did get those series of packages of crawdad imitators from Dick's the last time. This was only $1.99. So I figured, hey, if it gives me a good presentation, a good claw-forward presentation, I can use it. I want to work them sort of like a tube. I do rig tubes in different ways a lot of times. I've grew up rigging tubes with things like taking a wine cork and coring out the wine cork that it would slide and fit into the tube to add buoyancy to the tube. I then, moved on in years and more recently, in the last 8, 10, 15 years, I started using the foam rubber earplugs that adds buoyancy to a certain extent. And more importantly, I use that to hold scent, especially gel scents, into my tubes. And what I want to do is I want to try to use this to rig up my craw patterns baits, but rig them up so the fishing it, jigging it up and down, it's going to pull away, and instead of swimming towards you, I want it to pendulum and swim away from me. So the craws would be facing back, I can pull it up, and then it'll flutter with those craws suspended outward and swim away. And I'm thinking I can get that action out of these back-weighted hooks. So we'll see. You know, it might work out the way I want to, it might not. Time will tell. So I got some cotton cordels, $3.99 for these cotton cordel. This is the obviously made in China. This is smoky minnow in a little floating topwater bait. I like that. I got a cotton cordel for my smaller tackle in this bright chartreuse. CRD Big O in chartreuse. It's a medium diver. Again, for fishing for the little fish in a little deeper sections of the water. I like this pattern that came out. There was a couple of these. This was the most cleanly designed scallops. You could actually make out the scallops very well in this one. It's a Norman Lures. It's a 12 to 14 foot diver crank with that craw pattern. So you can get down there and get the craws in the center of the lake. Another Smith Deep Rattle and Rogue jerkbait. So another diving. Actually suspending. Silver Shiner is the color, Smoke Silver Shiner. Paid $3.99 for that, less my 10% off. I got this Cotton Cordell's half ounce little lipless, $3.99. Again, it's a shad pattern. Let's see what color they call this. This one they call Foxy Mama. Okay, Foxy Mama is the pattern on this one. Pull that out. But, again, standard little good rattles for a cotton cordel lipless crank. Add that to my repertoire of my rattle traps. Obviously, this that time of year. While I was there, I did also pick up for a hopeful future. I got myself two new little clamp-on rod holders, hopefully for my kayak. I can get that set up and ready to go because I needed to replace the ones that I had. I did pick up for $1.99. They had some Mustad Ultra Points in the 3/0, so it's always good to have extra hooks on hand. And for my musky fishing, a bright, giant, god-awful, obnoxious orange diver in the Norman Lures. This is their fluorescent orange deep diver 14. That's definitely worthwhile pitching out. And I got some jointed, larger jointed swing baits all by Strike Pro. These are their Flex Phantoms. I got four Flex Phantoms. These were $5.99 each. I just got them in a series of different colors. This is the Midnight Special, which is like a black auburn green. I got it in this one, which is the black green back ghost color, which has got that blue clear see-through. Then I got it in more of a neutral tone. This one is their gray ghost. It's very transparent. And this one reminds me more of like a sort of like a trout pattern, just because of the iridescence that shows up in it. You can catch a little glimpse of purple and green and blue, especially on the top part of the head up here. Again, it's a jointed little swim bait. I just, you know, for my long throwing rod, my bigger rod with my heavier line, I think I can pull in some larger trophy predator fish with this. And I did get it also in their larger size that they had available. This again is in that same, this is their Lake Fork Perch, but it, to me, it's very similar, kind of a buy between the ghost here, the Midnight Special, and that ghost color. But it's just a larger size of the same design bait, just larger upscale hooks, larger upscale bill, larger upscale body. And these are all single trebles. Yeah, let me not spike myself. So I'm interested to fish that big bad boy, you know, very shortly. And I do like, again, these are those wire joints, but I like this because this tail will actually pivot down either way. So it's gonna, to me, theoretically, it should give me a much more erratic action. It's not just gonna be your more rigid clacking back and forth S-waver style. Because of the way it turns, it should give me a more rolling, erratic kind of action depending on my retrieve. So I'm looking forward to that. Just felt like throwing this video real quick. You know, it's a short, like, 10-minute video or whatever. But, like I said, if the cabin fever gets to you, sometimes you spend a little extra spare change and see what you come up with. But in the long run, I hope to have a bunch of videos out there coming up shortly, now that work is, it's not really slowing down, but I'm getting along, the vacations are coming, it's summer, so I'm going to have a little bit of free time that I can actually make it out and show you some on-the-water stuff with a lot of these baits. Especially, I want to do some back creek stuff with the smaller micro lures. I hope this was entertaining. A little quick change of pace, a little relaxation the 9th of May here, and thought that, you know, you guys might like to just check it out. As always, I appreciate you spending a little time with me. Quick little video, nothing special, not a whole big diatribe, but if you enjoyed it, if you like any of this stuff, go out to your local Ollies, join the Ollies Army, and you can catch all these and get those little 10% off coupons. It makes it budget-friendly, it makes it, especially now, as everybody, like myself included, are taking care to you know, manage our finances. But you can still find some great deals, 99 cents on some hooks, $1.99 on a whole series of lures. Even when you do get up to the larger lures, you know, $6 when you go on Tackle Warehouse, you might find something similar to this. Probably a better quality, Maybe not. I mean, it's Strike Pro, which is still a name brand. But, you know, a more modern design than this one. This is a later dated design. But, you know, why would you spend $12, $15, $18, $20 for a swim bait? You can try this out and get into the swim bait game for $6. So, good luck to y'all out there. Hope to see you shortly, as always. Thank you for stopping by and spending some time with me. Hope this add a little bit of a break in your day. And as always, tight lines. I'll catch you on the next cast. Peace, Hookaholics.